r/AskReddit. What's an unusually strange historical event that few people know of? If you want to join my giveaway for $500, subscribe and you will be automatically entered. There was a period in the Middle Ages of knights fighting giant snails in paintings. No one knows why. I mean, this wasn't an event per se, but it is one of my favorite stories. When the Titanic was sinking, the head chef aboard knew the ship was going down. So he decided to take as much wine as he could and drink it. His logic was it was going to the bottom of the ocean anyway, so why not? Anyway, so he gets pretty tipsy and continues to eat all the food he can find, because Lord knows how long they would be out there. The man also filled at least one lifeboat with food and drinks, but decided not to get on yet. So the boat is starting to do that iconic tilting into the air, and the head chef decides to climb onto the railing and walk across it, since it was basically a walkway at that point. Gets to the propellers just as the boat breaks in half and he rides it down. He gets to the top and spends as much time he can out of the water by riding it down before being submerged into the ocean. He then waited for the lifeboats to come back and was one of the few people who survived while being in the water that night. The Great Stork Derby. A Toronto financier left a part of his estate to whatever woman in the city could produce the most children in the decade following his death. Hitler, Mussolini, and Stalin have all been nominated for the Nobel Peace Prize. The Boston Great Molasses Disaster of 1919-21. People died and 150 were injured. The Rasputin connection to the source of the All Persons fictitious disclaimer on American films and TV shows. The Halifax explosion. In 1917, a munitions ship detonated, creating the largest non-nuclear man-made explosion in history. Thousands died. Thousands were injured. And the ship was burning long enough to attract enough attention that the detonation blinded even thousands more. Boston participated heavily in responding to the disaster. To this day, Nova Scotia donates the Christmas tree that is displayed publicly in Boston every year. The legend of the Green Children of Woolpit concerns two children of unusual skin color who reportedly appeared in the village of Woolpit in Suffolk, England, sometime in the 12th century, perhaps during the reign of King Stephen. The children, brother and sister, were of generally normal appearance except for the green color of their skin. They spoke in an unknown language and would only eat raw broad beans. Eventually they learned to eat other food and lost their green pallor. But the boy was sickly and died soon after he and his sister were baptized. The girl adjusted to her new life, but she was considered to be rather loose and wanton in her conduct, too, after she learned to speak English. The girl explained that she and her brother had come from St. Martin's Land, a subterranean world inhabited by green people. Sybil Ludington rode 40 miles to her town to gather 400 troops and warn them that the British were coming to attack. This happened in 1777 and she is often overshadowed by Paul Revere. Sybil was a 14-year-old girl who was on her horse Star when she did this in the middle of the night, waking troops by banging a stick on fence posts and other objects. There is currently a sculpture of her in New York, but Paul Revere is often recognized first. When the Mongols at their height of power conquered China, they were still in their phase of killing all the people and burning their cities to turn it back to pasture for their horses. Huge swaths of Central Asia had already been treated, so laid to waste. There was one guy, I don't remember what his name was, a northern tribesman who'd fought against the Mongols but been captured and joined them when they were deciding what to do with China. He convinced the Mongols there was more profit in leaving as it was and levying taxes, with which the Mongols could buy whatever they wanted. Apparently that hadn't occurred to the Mongols before, but that one guy definitely saved millions of lives. Robert Lincoln, Abraham's only surviving son, was pushed into the path of an oncoming train and was subsequently saved by Edwin Booth, John Wilkes, Acker Abe's killer brother. It isn't super significant, just a silly twist of fate. In the 1980s, Domino's Pizza introduced a mascot named Nanoid. Its main goal: stealing pizzas and making your pizza delivery late. The slogan: avoid the Noid. Unfortunately, there was a man with paranoid schizophrenia named Kenneth Noid who thought this whole campaign was created to mock and persecute him due to the mascot's name. So one day, Noid entered an Atlanta Domino's location and took two employees hostage. During the 5-hour standoff, he got hungry. So he ordered the employees to make him some pizzas. Of course, he didn't pay for any of them, thus inadvertently living up to the Noid's tendency to steal pizzas. He was eventually apprehended and spent some time in a mental institution until his death in 1995. Meanwhile, Domino's retired the mascot due to what had happened and it was never mentioned again. When Aum Shinrikyo, the Japanese death cult responsible for the sarin gas attack on the Tokyo subway, bought a ranch in the Australian outback and apparently got up to all kinds of shenanigans. That time a dentist got pissed at Japan because of the bombing of Pearl Harbor, so he declared war on Japan and suggested making bombs using bats. And the US military actually went through with attempting to make them. They only stopped making their bat bombs because they developed the nuke. The Dancing Plague of 1518. In 1979, the US space station Skylab was deorbited. Some of the debris that survived re-entry landed in rural Australia. And they jokingly gave NASA a $400 fine for littering. The fine wasn't paid for 3 decades until a US radio host raised the money. In 1916, they sentenced an elephant to death because he killed a circus worker. They executed this by hanging the elephant on a crane. Oliver Cromwell's posthumous execution. Also, a German U-boat in World War II was sunk due to a toilet. https://en.m.wikipedia.org/wiki/german_submarine_u-1206. Most Australians know about Darwin getting bombed in World War II and they were. Barely anyone knows that Broome was bombed a fair bit too. I never got taught this in school either. Had to read a book to find out. Quite annoying that only Darwin's bombings gets taught just because it's the capital of NT and Broome is in the far north of WA, so no one cares. There was a span of time where clocks were already a thing but were too luxurious for the average citizen. But most cities had one on their church or something. And since the day starts a little bit different everywhere, every city had their own time zone. It had to be generalized over the globe because of industrial revolution and railroads getting more popular, but it still took a very long time for every village to be convinced that it would be better to adapt. The Anglo-Zanzibar War, a military conflict that was fought on the 27th of August, 1897 between the United Kingdom and the Zanzibar Sultanate, that lasted approximately 45 minutes. Making it the shortest war in history. In the late 1800s into the mid-1900s, it was common for there to be so much pollution in the Cuyahoga River in Ohio that it would regularly light on fire. 13 times. https://en.wikipedia.org/wiki/Cuyahoga_river. At least 13 fires have been reported on the Cuyahoga River. The first occurring in 1868, 12, 18, the largest river fire, in 1952, caused over $1 million in damage, 12, to boats, a bridge, and a riverfront office building, dead link, 19. Secondary fun fact from history, Kodak found out about nuclear detonations by using corn silk to pack their film, which would be messed up due to the radioactive fallout, and the government used their film. So the US government began telling Kodak when they were detonating nukes. And where. So that they could ensure they did not use radioactive corn silk to pack their film. They never told the US public that they were eating irradiated food. https://www.imaging-resource.com/news/2013/02/26/not-so-secret-atomic-bomb-tests-y-the-photographic-film-industry-new. On the 16th of September, 1920, there was a terrorist attack on Wall Street. At 12:01, 100 pounds of dynamite exploded in front of the corner at JP Morgan. Within minutes, Wall Street looked like a war zone. Hundreds of pounds of metal fragments, which had been concealed inside the wagon that had hidden the bomb, filled the streets with shrapnel. Burned bodies littered the sidewalks and smoke filled the air. No one ever claimed responsibility or was arrested. The bombing of Harvey's Resort in Nevada was one of the most destructive in US history. But few people have heard about it because there were zero fatalities. From the article, the bomb, one of the largest the FBI had ever seen, was loaded with an estimated 1,000 pounds, 450 kg, of dynamite stolen from a construction site in Fresno, California. According to FBI experts, the Harvey's bomb remains the most complex improvised explosive device they have examined, and a replica of the machine, as the extortionists called it, was still used in FBI training as of 2009. A B-52 with a payload of thermonuclear bombs broke apart and crashed near Goldsboro, North Carolina in 1961. One of the bombs nearly detonated. Three of its four arming mechanisms had activated. That time the Swiss military got lost and accidentally invaded Liechtenstein. The Tuskegee Syphilis Experiments. 600 impoverished black men were recruited so researchers could study the natural course of syphilis. None of the men were told they had the disease, only that they would receive free medical treatment and meals. It was supposed to last 6 months, but went on for 40 years. When the study first started, penicillin had not been discovered as a way to treat the disease. After it was, none of the men in the study were treated for it, leading to unnecessary progression of and death by syphilis. Not a fun way to go. This shitty shit behavior is part of why clinical trials require informed consent and much more stringent ethics criteria. Fidel Castro survived over 600 assassination attempts which varied in range of different ideas. An exploding cigar was once used. One of my favorite historical stories is the story of False Dmitri. It's funny stuff. Napoleon II, I think, was terrified of being assassinated, so he commissioned a secret entrance to the opera while it was in construction. It had its own boulevard and direct passage to his box. He died before he could ever use it. Directed by Robert B. Wiley. The Catholic Church sold 272 slaves to keep Georgetown University open and running. Circa 1838. English sweating sickness. A high mortality contagion with strange symptoms that mysteriously appeared in 1485 and just as mysteriously disappeared in 1551. The Carrington event. A solar event so strong that if it happened today it'd probably send most of the world back to the Dark Ages. Telegraph systems all over Europe and North America failed. In some cases giving telegraph operators electric shocks. Telegraph pylons threw sparks. Some telegraph operators could continue to send and receive messages despite having disconnected their power supplies. I've heard the story, but had to look it up to retell it. In 1809, Jean Todd Crawford rode on horseback from Greensburg, KY to Danville, KY, 60 miles, at the age of 44. She needed an abdominal tumor removed. The surgery was performed on Christmas Day by Dr. Ephraim McDowell on his kitchen table. Without anesthetic. A part of the fallopian tube, along with 22.5 pounds of stuff the tumor, was removed. After 25 days, she returned home, via horseback, so the story goes, on the same path. It was considered the first successful intentional opening of the abdominal cavity to remove something. She died at 78. 1811, 1812, New Madrid earthquakes. Between December 1811 and February 1812. Three earthquakes. All above 7.0 on the Richter scale. The 7th of February earthquake is estimated to have been as high as an 8.6 on the Richter scale. Struck the Mazurabutil region. Memphis experienced level IX, violent, shaking on the MMI scale. Although damage was light due to the sparse population in the region at the time. In 2008, FEMA estimated that an earthquake like this happening today could result in the highest economic losses due to a disaster in United States history. In the next 50 years, it is estimated that there is a 7 to 10% chance of an earthquake ranging from magnitude 7.6 to 8.0 occurring in that region, and a 25 to 40% chance of a magnitude 6.0 or greater earthquake happening within the same time frame. Call of Duty. Zombies Group 935 is based on a real Japanese unit which performed biochem experiments on humans during World War II. I thought I knew all about World War II until I stumbled on this gory nugget. Wiki link to Unit 731. Connecticut once owned and subsequently sold part of Ohio. The Connecticut Western Reserve. The Nazis had an actual working Motherfucking tornado cannon. The only reason it wasn't used during the war was that it wasn't efficient compared to ordinary missiles. Also, Indiana Jones probably took it out. Thanks to Russia wanting Pepsi and being unable to pay for it with cash, Pepsi was briefly the sixth largest naval power on the planet due to being paid in Russian naval vessels. They sold the ships for scrap. But imagine if they'd kept it. Mad Jack Churchill. Only soldier who had a confirmed kill with a longbow. Charged Germans with a claymore. Played Amazing Grace on his bagpipes as he got captured. In 1915, the SS Eastland rolled over in the Chicago River, killing 800 people. It's hard to imagine a boat accident that deadly right next to land. But it remains the worst loss of life on the Great Lakes. Or something like that. When a Finnish teenager took a Cessna 172 across Western Russia and landed on a bridge in Moscow, then taxied to the front steps of the Kremlin to make a statement, he would have had 14 months, years perhaps, in a gulag if Gorbachev didn't grant his freedom to gain political favor. He almost got shot down by a MiG. But they figured he was a training flight for the USSR Air Force or whatever. Absolute mad lad. The Battle for Castle Itta. The eugenics policies of the United States from the late 1800s to the late 1900s. Before 1933, California sterilized 4 times as many people, voluntarily and non-voluntarily, as the next 4 countries who practiced sterilization of its citizens combined. Hitler got very excited about the program and modeled his own after it. The Taiping Rebellion of 1850 to 1864 was the second most deadly singular conflict in history, at 25 million deaths, only beaten by the Second World War. The Tunguska event. An explosion the size of a 10-30 megaton nuclear blast in a remote Russian forest in 1908. That's over 1,000 times more powerful than the Hiroshima atomic bomb. It knocked down 80 million trees over 830 square miles and was observed around the globe as far as Washington, D.C. It was believed to be a meteorite exploding. But no crater was found, and it's believed the debris burned up in the atmosphere after the explosion. The Black Tom explosion. Nobody I know was taught anything about this in school, including college. https://en.m.wikipedia.org/wiki/black_tom_explosion. The US Army Air Force almost tried to use bats laden with incendiary bombs on timers against Japanese cities. The idea being they would release the bats over the city. Then the bats would hide in hard to reach places. And then go boom, starting fires everywhere and in hard to reach places. A test was so successful they nearly burned down a US base with 4 bats. The Irish drunk flood. When 3 million metric fuck tons of alcohol was flooded to the streets of Dublin, 13 people died due to alcohol poisoning. Shortly after the US Civil War, a bunch of Irish and Irish-American soldiers attempted to invade and take Canada from the British on behalf of the United States. That time that the UK USA made a giant fire tornado in World War II. https://en.wikipedia.org/wiki/bombing_of_hamburg_in_world_war_ii. The Pig War on San Juan Island off the coast of Washington State. About 1859. The territory was claimed by both the UK and the US. Both, subsequently, had troops on the island. An American shot a British pig and https://en.m.wikipedia.org/wiki/pig_war_1859. More of a misconception. But Nero didn't play the flute as Rome burned. His favorite instrument was the lyre, and he wasn't in the city at the time of the Great Fire. from 1984-85, some Japanese candy companies were blackmailed by a person or group of people calling themselves the monster with 21 faces. It's actually really fascinating. Basically, they sent letters to a candy company telling them they had put cyanide into their products, causing the company to lose 20 million inches profit. They then turned their attention to another company and they actually drove the police superintendent to suicide. They then randomly stopped after that, sending a goodbye letter. No one was ever caught or identified. Though they caught a suspicious person on video and an undercover agent saw a strange man following him one night. It's actually really fascinating, like something out of a movie. The Lake Nyas disaster in 1986. A limnic eruption happened in the lake and released 100,300 tons of CO2. The gas rose at 100 kilometers per hour and then near instantly suffocated the surrounding area within 25 kilometers of the lake. 1,746 people died from the event. No one really knows what triggered the event. TLDR. A lake mass murdered everything with CO2. More info. https://en.wikipedia.org/wiki/lake_Nyas. Most Americans don't know about the 30 Years War, which was an unbelievably complicated clusterfuck that killed 20% of the German population. In Prague, there were a couple hundred years where killing politicians by throwing them out windows was commonplace. https://en.wikipedia.org/wiki/defenestrations_of_Prague. During the Cold War and the Cuban blockade, a Russian sub almost fired a nuclear torpedo. The blockade was already firing practice depth charges and hammering the sub. It works on a buddy system and they both said yes, except this time there was a political officer who also has a say and he said no and surfaced and was surrounded by US warships. Operation Mincemeat. Ian Fleming, the creator of James Bond, came up with the idea to have the dead body of a British Marine officer discovered by Nazi Germany with top secret documents on his person so that they would be misled into thinking that the invasion of certain Mediterranean islands was going to happen different Mediterranean islands. Australian Anzac troops in Germany during World War I spotted a broken down, useless German tank in the middle of no man's land. They called artillery and airplanes to distract the Germans who had machine guns and hauled the tank back behind friendly lines. Purely because they could. The tank was a model called the Mephisto. The last of its kind. It still sits in the Brisbane Museum to this day. All because a bunch of mad cunts wanted a shitty tank. 2,000 people were killed by a volcanic eruption in British Columbia 250 years ago. Google NAS lava beds. Scheinman Square. The fire in Peshtigo, Wisconsin on the 8th of October, 1871. Between 1,500 and 2,500 people were killed and over 1 million acres burned. Didn't get much press because it happened the same day as the Great Chicago Fire, in which about 300 people perished and destroyed 3.3 square miles. I've been listening to a lot of The Dollop, so there are options. The Kentucky Meat Shower comes to mind. Everything involving the Willie D. United Way destroying Cleveland with balloons. Andrew Jackson and Too Much Cheese, that one just became an obvious children's book title. 10 Cent Beer Night is probably my favorite, but it doesn't have much to do with anything. It was just a hilariously bad idea. In 1982, the Florida Keys seceded from the Union, called themselves the Conch Republic, and declared war on the US for all of 1 minute. The British losing to the Boers in their first battle. Canada has a heist nearly 3,000 tons of maple syrup in 2011-2012. They stole it from a cartel that controls 77% of the global maple syrup supply. In 1794, it rained toads in Lalaine, near a French city called Lille. This event was witnessed by soldiers. Julianne Cope was on a plane that crashed over a rainforest in the early 70s. She was the sole survivor of the crash, managing to adapt to her new environment after living in the jungle for a while as a child. She wandered for 11 days before being found, and is now works in the biology field in Peruvian jungles. like and subscribe if you want to.